Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. In this video, we are going to cover the current affairs of 12th of February. For mobile optimized ebooks, please install GKToday Academy app. Now, one more thing. If you find these videos helpful, please share it. Despite repetitive requests, hardly 100 people share it. There is no point of doing this much work when not many people are watching it. So, if it is helpful, please share it. Now, let's start. Which city is host to the 13th UN Convention on Conservation of Migratory Species 2020? So, Gandhinagar in Gujarat is the host of this convention, and it is going to be the COP13, that is 13th Conference of Parties. And the theme of this year's summit is Migratory Species Connect the Planet and We Welcome Them Home. And Prime Minister of India, Mr. Modi, will inaugurate this summit. Now, Gandhinagar is in Gujarat, and recently Gujarat was in news as the Chief Minister of Gujarat, Mr. Vijay Rupani, inaugurated second tallest statue of Sardar Patel in Ahmedabad. The tallest statue of Sardar Patel is also in Gujarat, and it is Statue of Unity. And recently, it was included in the list of 8 wonders of SCO. SCO stands for Shanghai Cooperation Organization. Headquarters of SCO is in Beijing. It should be noted that though the name of organization is Shanghai Cooperation Organization, the headquarters is in Beijing. Apart from that, Gujarat was also in news as recently KVIC, that is Khadi and Village Industries Commission, inaugurated their first silk processing plant in Gujarat, and this plant is for Patola Saris. Answer in comment box, KVIC is under which ministry? And is it a statutory body or an executive body? Recently, Supreme Court of India upheld the Scheduled Caste and Scheduled Tribes Amendment Act. Now, the question is, when was the original Act of 1989 amended? Actually, in March 2018, the Supreme Court gave a judgment diluting the original Act. Now, why this judgment was given? Because as per NCRB report, NCRB is National Crime Record Bureau, this Act was misused. So, Supreme Court, considering this NCRB report, diluted this Act. Diluted means Supreme Court provided the provisions for anticipatory bail. Now, what is anticipatory bail? Anticipatory bail means pre-arrest bail. It means you anticipate that you are going to be arrested, therefore you approach the court for bail and court grant you bail. This is anticipatory bail. Now, as per this SCST Act, this anticipatory bail was not allowed. However, after the Supreme Court verdict, this anticipatory bail was allowed, and therefore it diluted the main purpose of this act. Subsequently, the Parliament of India amended this act to prevent this anticipatory bail, and now Supreme Court of India has upheld this amendment act. So now anticipatory bail can be provided only in rarest of the rare, that means in extraordinary circumstances, by the High Court. American Factory, which won the Oscar for the best feature-length documentary, was produced by which famous American personality? So, it was produced by the former President of America, Mr. Barack Obama. So, recently this American Factory documentary won the Oscar award, and this was the first documentary released by the Barack and Michelle Obama's production company named Higher Ground. And this documentary was released on Netflix, and recently it won the Oscar award. Now, we have covered Oscar awards in our last video, so you can check that. Which bird is named as the mascot of UN Convention of Conservation of Migratory Species? So the mascot is GIB, that is Great Indian Bustard. Now, it should be noted that India has recently proposed to include 3 species in the list of migratory species threatened with extinction. And these 3 species are Asian elephant, Great Indian Bustard, and Bengal floricon. Now, if we talk about this CMS, that is Convention on Migratory Species, it is also known as Bonn Convention, and it is an international agreement to conserve the migratory species. Now, it should be noted that This agreement was signed under the UNEP. UNEP stands for United Nations Environment Program, and it was formed in 1972 on 5th of June. And 5th of June is celebrated as Environment Day. Now, the headquarters of UNEP is in Kenya, in Nairobi. And recently, Kenya was in news as Kenya's longest serving president, Mr. Daniel Arap Moi, passed away. In fact, the headquarters of Oxfam is also in Nairobi, in Kenya. Now, answer in comment box, does Equator passes through Kenya? Ajay Warrior is a joint military exercise conducted between India and which country? So, it is a exercise between India and UK, and this time it will be conducted in UK. And the armies of India and UK are going to participate in this exercise. Now, if we talk about UK, recently UK was in news as UK announced the donation of £20 million for developing vaccine to coronavirus. Now, this donation is to be given to CEPI. CEPI stands for Coalition for Epidemic Preparedness Innovations, and it is a public-private coalition, and the headquarters of CEPI is in Norway, in Oslo. And CEPI was launched at Davos in 2017. And recently, Davos was in news as World Economic Forum Summit held in Davos. And during this summit, Mr. Piyush Goyal led the Indian delegation. Now, if we talk about coronavirus, first, this N-coronavirus started in Wuhan in China. And in India, the first case of coronavirus was found in Kerala. Which Union Ministry releases the Public Enterprises Survey on the performance of central public sector enterprises? So, it is released by Ministry of Heavy Industries and Public Enterprises. Now, I have uploaded a special video on this topic. You can watch that. Which state government recently launched the Reading Mission initiative for students? So, it is an initiative by the state government of Haryana. And the objective of this initiative is to inculcate the reading habit among the young students of state. Now, Haryana was also in news because of Surajkund Mela. And for this year, the theme state for Haryana for this Surajkund Mela was Himachal Pradesh. On which date the World Pulses Day is observed across the country? So, it is observed on 10th of February. And on 10th of February, National Deworming Day is also observed. And this World Pulses Day was announced by UNGA, that is United Nations General Assembly. And this day is celebrated to raise awareness about the nutritional values of pulses. Which Union Ministry has recently launched the web portal for star rating of coal mines? So recently, Ministry of Coal has launched a web portal for star rating of coal mines. Now, it should be noted that all operational coal mines will be enabled for self-rating, and then these mines will be validated by the CCO. CCO stands for Coal Controllers Organization, and it is a subordinate office of Ministry of Coal. And this mechanism would award a star rating to the mines. Now, if we talk about coal, recently, Mr. Pramod Agarwal took charge as the new chairman and MD of Coal India Limited. Apart from that, recently, government launched Prakash Portal, and the full form of this Prakash is Power Rail Koila Availability Through Supply Harmony. So, it is a collaboration between the Ministry of Power, Ministry of Coal and Indian Railways for a coal supply to power plants. The storm Ciara recently hit several countries of which continent? So, this storm was in news because of damage in Europe, and several European countries witnessed this devastating storm Ciara, and this storm moved near to Germany after hitting Britain and Ireland, and it was called Ciara by the Irish Weather Service, and in Germany it was called as Sabine. Which city plays host to the first cultural festival called Jerusalem Mumbai Festival? So, The name itself suggests this is to be hosted by Mumbai. And this is first such joint event for Jerusalem in an Asian city. So this festival is to be celebrated to promote ties between India and Israel. That means to boost relationship between these two countries. Now, if we talk about Mumbai, recently Kala Ghoda Art Festival also held in Mumbai. Apart from that, from 27th of January, Mumbai is to remain open for 24/7. That means 24 hours and on 7 days. So, this became a city which never sleeps. Mumbai was also in news as recently ICMR, that is Indian Council of Medical Research, released a report of sugar intake in our country. And as per this report, Mumbai has the highest sugar intake in our country. And Ahmedabad is on second position. Which famous cricketer of Australia received the Allan Border medal from Cricket Australia? So, right answer is David Warner. So, Australian cricketer David Warner won the Allan Border medal of Cricket Australia for being the player of the year, while Alice Perry won the Belinda Clark Award. Now, if we talk about Australia, Australia was also in news as recently a new virus was detected in mosquitoes in Australia, and the name of this virus is Yada Yada. Australia was also in news as recently Kiran Majumdar's show was conferred Order of Australia. Which automobile firm is set to acquire the automotive business of Ford India? So recently, CCI, that is Competition Commission of India, approved the formation of JV, that means joint venture, between Mahindra and Mahindra and Ford Motor to transfer the automotive business of Ford India to this JV. So this joint venture is between Mahindra and Mahindra and Ford India. Jiri Vasily, who clinched the Tata Open Maharashtra 2020, is from which country? So he is from Czech Republic, and recently he won the Tata Open Maharashtra 2020, and this event held in Pune. Last time this event held in Chennai. As per the latest study of NCRB, which state records the highest number of missing women? So recently, NCRB compiled the data on missing children and women on the directions of Supreme Court. And as per this data, Maharashtra records the highest number of missing women in last 3 years. Maharashtra is on top in terms of highest number of missing women, and it is followed by West Bengal and Madhya Pradesh. It should be noted that the highest number of missing children was reported in Maharashtra and in West Bengal. Now, this data was compiled by NCRB. NCRB stands for National Crime Records Bureau. It is under Ministry of Home Affairs. Present Home Minister is Mr. Amit Shah, and recently he was in news as he chaired the 6th meeting of IDA. IDA stands for Island Development Agency. So, this agency was constituted for the development of islands of our country. Mr. Amit Shah was also in news as recently he released a book titled Karam Yodha Granth, and this book is based on the life of our Prime Minister Mr. Modi. The National Online Platform for Public Procurement Government E-Marketplace was launched in which year? So this was launched in 2016, and it is under Union Ministry of Commerce. Now, it was in news recently because this GEM facilitated the public procurement worth rupee 40,000 crores through this online portal. Now, this GEM, that is Government E-Marketplace, is under Commerce Ministry, and recently Commerce Ministry was in news as Union Government announced that National Startup Advisory Council will be set up, and this council will advise the central government to create suitable environment for startup company, and this council will be headed by Union Commerce Minister. Now, this Commerce Ministry was also in news as recently DPIIT under Commerce Ministry launched paperless licensing process for petroleum service stations, and this was done through PESO. PESO is Petroleum and Explosives Safety Organization. DPIIT stands for Department of Promotion of Industry and Internal Trade. EDFS, that is Electronic Dealer Financing Scheme, is a flagship product of which Indian public sector bank? So, it is an initiative of State Bank of India, and recently SBI partnered with mobile phone manufacturer Realme to offer credit facilities, and this partnership is made under bank's EDFS scheme. So under this partnership, the dealers and distributors of Realme would get access to the credit facilities at low interest rate and at minimum collateral. So this is an initiative for the distributors and dealers of Realme, mobile manufacturing company. Now, State Bank of India was also in news, as recently it was declared as the lead convener bank for Union Territory of Ladakh, while SBI is the lead convener bank for Ladakh, and Jammu and Kashmir Bank is the lead convener bank for Union Territory of Jammu and Kashmir. State Bank of India was also in news because of residential builder finance with buyer guarantee scheme. Which Indian hockey player was named as the 2019 Women's Rising Star of the Year by FIH? Recently, Ms. Lal Rimziami has been named as the 2019 FIH Women's Rising Star of the Year, and she is from Mizoram. On the other hand, in men's category, Mr. Vivek Sagar was named as 2019 Rising Star of the Year. Now, if we talk about hockey, recently Ms. Rani Rampal was named World Games Athlete of the Year, and she became the first ever hockey player to win this award. Apart from that, India is going to be the host of Men's Hockey World Cup in 2023. Answer in comment box which country will host the 2022 Women's Hockey World Cup. The Institute of Financial Management is set to be renamed after which former Union Minister? It will be renamed after Mr. Arun Jaitley, who was our Union Finance Minister. So the new name of this institute is going to be Arun Jaitley National Institute of Financial Management, and this is in Faridabad, and Faridabad is in Haryana, and this institute was established in 1993 under Department of Expenditure. This Department of Expenditure is under Finance Ministry, and Union Finance Minister act as the president of this institute. On which date International Day of Women and Girls in Science is celebrated across the world? So it is celebrated on 11th of February. Now, if we talk about science, recently 107th edition of Indian Science Congress held in Bengaluru, and the theme of this event was Science and Technology, Rural Development. Apart from that, recently the Farmers Science Congress was conducted for the first time in Bengaluru. So these were the most important questions of today's quiz. Thank you, and that's all for the day.